Have you ever clicked on a beautiful data visualization in ServiceNow, expecting to be whisked away to a detailed list, only to find nothing happens? Or maybe you have wondered, how do those magical clicks actually know where to take me? Well, you are not alone. Today, I am going to reveal the secret pathway behind the ServiceNow UI Builder, how you can make your dashboard not just look amazing, but actually do amazing things with event mapping and scripting. If you have ever wanted your user to feel like they are driving through a seamless interactive experience, this is a video for you. So let me take you on a journey. Imagine you are an architect of a futuristic city, ServiceNow City. You are building a stunning skyscraper. We can call it as your dashboard. But now you want to connect them with a magical portal and event so that anyone can travel from one building to another with a single step. That we call as a click. But here is a twist. This portal doesn't just appear on their own. You need to craft them, set their destination, and sometimes even write some little magical spell to make sure they just work right. So in today's tutorial, what we'll be doing, we'll go to the UI Builder. We'll try to create one data visualization. We'll be creating as a first step. The second step, we'll be creating a list view. And then we'll try to connect both of them in the third step. I hope it's clear. So without wasting further time, let's get started. So what we'll do as a first step, we'll just go to UI Builder. And we'll open the UI Builder. So this is the fourth video in my series, UI Builder series. If you haven't seen my previous video, just go and watch through it so that you will get the basic understanding. And we'll continue from the point where we left the things from the in the first tutorials. So we'll open our UI Builder experience. Perfect. Okay. And we'll open our home default one only. Over here, we have added a lot of garbage things. Okay. But now what we'll do, we'll add one more two column kind of things. Okay. And over here, I will add a data visualization. Perfect. I don't want to complicate things. You can create all kind of data visualization from here, but I want to just go with a simple data visualization. That is single score. So I'll go with that. Now we have to define some data, right? To be shown on the single score, what single score you want to see. So for that, we will go to a data. First, we will change. We want to show incidents which are active and critical. Okay. So I will give a name as active critical incidents. Okay. And I can turn it to H1 also. And here I can give this is a test data. I can give some description if I want. Okay. And now we will add the data. So how you can add data? I have clicked on data source and I can search for incident over there. And incident. Now you can add conditions. So currently you can see there are 70 incidents as a whole. Okay. Now we want to add a condition. Sorry, it's 70. I will add a condition like active is true and what priority, right? Priority is critical. Hopefully there will be some data out there. Okay, so if I run, so we got 70 records. So our end goal is like when we click on a data visualization, we should be able to see 70 records. That's it. Okay, so we'll do add this to the source. Okay, now the first step got completed. We have created a data visualization. Perfect. If you want to do some styling and all those things, you can do it. Okay. But I will keep it as is for now. Now, as a part of next step, what we have to do, first we'll save this out. We'll complete the first step. Now we have to go to the UI experience and we have to create a new page. Okay. Where we will be routing the things out. So I will go to plus, create a new page. Again, I will create it from scratch. Okay. And I will give it name as incident data list. Data list, for instance, I will do continue. Now it asks for parameters, right? So this time I will be adding a parameter. So in required parameters, I will give table, which will go with incident, and I will also give query. In query, we'll be passing what should be the query for getting the data. That is act equal to true, and what else? And priority is critical. So I will just go to looks good. I will not add any variant. Okay, I will just continue. Build responsive. Okay, fine. And that's it. So we'll let it come. Okay. Now, as a part of first step, we'll just go add content. I will add single column. And in this, I will add style text. Okay. And let's try to make it more sensible. So I will just go to script, what we have seen in the last tutorial, and we will go with API dot, what was that? API dot context dot, I want to build something like this. Okay, let's see. We will be building hi user. Okay, welcome to incident list, something like this. Okay, so I can click this only, control X, and I will do in return, I'll just go, or I can give variable message equal to what just happened. Hi user. Now I will just go with hi, and this user should be dynamic one. So I can give hi, then plus. So it will be API dot context dot session dot user. You remember, right? Dot what? First name, for instance. Okay. So this is done. We'll just add one more concatenation. We have just removed the user thing. So this is done, and we can give welcome to, so I will just remove this welcome to. Now again, this we can make it dynamic. Okay, how? I will tell you. Welcome to, I will just give list over here, list for, and then we will add in the last, I'll just change this out. Incident, how we can get again API dot. It's not coming. I have to do plus API dot context dot. Now here we can give properties dot table. Because this is what we have defined over there. Okay. And I will return message. Done. If I apply, and if I give it like in the table is incident, and if I give query as active equal to true, apply. So we should get some message. Hi system, welcome to the list for incident. Isn't it amazing, right? So this, and we will add, this was not part, not I thought I will be doing, but let's see. And I've added one more layout, and over here I will add list, and we'll go with a simple list for now. Now you can see, if I select over here the table as incident, incident how many records will be visible. So it's 43 records incident, and we can go with the fix filter. Okay, now we have added the incident. Now let's add the fix filter. So we'll get it from the query. So how we can get it? It's prop and query. We apply. It has given 43 records. So for active incident with critical, active incident, 43 records are there. We'll save this out. I didn't add priority just to show you the difference that data is getting changed. Okay. So we have completed our second step out. In second step, what we have done, we have created a new page, added a simple list component on it, and just map the parameters from the page, which is incident query. Now we'll try to bind it through the event, okay, from the data visualization. So we'll go back. I hope I have saved it out right. I hope I have saved, but I will go to default. Now over here, what you have to do, you have to click on this data visualization, and you can see over here events. So you click on event, add event mapping, and there are a lot of things out like, but most used one is visualization click. When you click on the visualization, what should happen? So we'll do visualization click, continue. What should happen? We want to link to a lot of actions are there, notifications and all those things, refresh and all those things out. But we just want to route it out to trigger screen navigation. So we will do link to destination. We'll do with continue. And here it will ask, what is the destination? Is it external URL or pages in current experience? So we have our page in current experience, right? So we'll select the incident data list page. And now, as you know, it has two attributes, right? We have mapped it out. So we'll just fix it out. So what should be table? So table should come from event payload, params, table. This should be the table. And query should be event payload, params, query. So from where this table and query is coming, this is coming from the data visualization itself. Okay. And I can click on add to add this event. Now, if I click over here, you see the entire thing got mapped correctly. Okay. So I will just do apply and I will just save this out. So the third step is also completed. Now let's see it in action. So I will just go here, open the workspace. We'll go to the UI Builder workspace and we'll go to the home. Okay. In home, we have this particular, or what we can say, data visualization. Now, if I click on it, it should route to that particular page. Okay. So if I click on this 17, it routed to this page 17. Let me just refresh it out why the message is not showing correctly. Yeah, it came up. Okay. So again, let's do that activity. So I will click on this particular activity. And now we got hi system, because this is my name of my user account which got logged in. If we can confirm it over here, system, welcome to the list of four incidents. It also came dynamically. And now we can see 70 records. From where the 70 records are coming? If I go to incident.list, and over here, if I add filter like active is true and priority is critical, it should give 70 records. Perfect, 70 records. So our configuration are working as expected. And just like that, we have transformed ServiceNow City into a place where every click is a magical journey, every chart is a gateway, and every user feels empowered and delighted. Now it's your turn. Go ahead, build your own magical pathway in ServiceNow UI Builder. If you found this story helpful, Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Your support helps this channel to grow, and let me bring you even more ServiceNow secrets and stories. Got questions or want to share your own UI Builder adventure? Drop them in the comment below. I would love hearing them from you. Thanks for watching, and remember, in ServiceNow, every click can be a new adventure. See you in the next video. Till then, thank you.